Hi guys, this is your girl Lorraine. No, this is your pastor and your friend Reverend Lorraine Bundi. I decided to do this video for you guys because I recognize that you are home now, and who knows for how long you will have to be home for. And so I thought, you know, maybe I can release a video for you guys maybe once or twice every week, very short videos to help you fill in this time in a godly, God-glorifying way. So here goes. Today I thought I would address what I think is can be bad use of a phone of your phone and the internet, because I recognize that you have a lot of time on your hands now. You have phones, you have bundles a lot of times, I presume. And so I thought I would address what I think is bad use of your phone and internet, and what can be good use of your phone and the internet. Some of the bad ways in which you can use your phone and the internet, and I know you know these things, is one, access to and watching pornography. Yeah. Two, watching and sharing inappropriate content. And guys, you know these things, because I know many of you have blocked me and your parents and your aunts and your uncles from your statuses, because you cannot have us see what it is you post on those statuses. So that, and taking inappropriate images of yourself and sending them to, you know, your girlfriend or your boyfriend or your friend with benefits. It's a bad use of your phone. Another thing would be cyberbullying. You know, the internet offers us anonymity. You can call yourself anything, you know. For example, let me, Anika, my brother, he calls himself Black Vanilla. You would never know who Black Vanilla is. And so, you know, offers you anonymity, and so you can use that anonymity to diss people or be rude or say things that you wouldn't have said if that person was seeing you face to face. And the last thing is doing attention seeking videos and writing attention seeking texts and things like that. One that has been prevalent this past week is this thing of write a secret message. I wouldn't know who it is. And you know the things that people have shared. You know the things that you have probably shared, again, because of anonymity, and what people have also shared. And I think it is a quest for affirmation and a need for you to feel that people like you, they love you, they consider you beautiful, and, you know, things like that. I think those are bad uses of your phone and of the internet. But I'm going to give you things that I think are good uses of your phone and the internet in this period of time. And I do hope that you use them to fill up your time in a way that will be fun for you and that will be God glorifying. One of these things is accessing sites with good content. Sites like Penstrokes. There's a gentleman, he's called Ernest Wamboye. He has a nice site for relationships and godly dating that's called Penstrokes. He writes many wonderful godly articles on this thing, so you can access that site. There is a site called Desiring God that has a lot of good content on many questions you probably have about your faith at this stage of your faith, so you can access Desiring God as well. And our very own website, Mamlaka Hill Chapel website, where we have our pastors writing articles on different subjects and different content as well, which can be very useful for you. I would encourage you to access this site. Another thing you can do, I know you guys are, some of you are YouTubers and some of you really follow YouTubers. And I'd like to give you a few YouTubers who you can follow who have very, very good and fun content for Christians such as you, because I hope that you are a Christian. One of them is a guy called Joseph Solomon on Chase God TV. Joseph Solomon on Chase God TV. He has very funny content that addresses our current and relevant issues as modern Christians. For example, secular music, should I go to church or should I not go to church? You know, things like that. He's very funny. It's very short videos. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. Another YouTuber you can follow is the Terry Winfred. She's a really good friend of mine. She comes here to Mamlaka Hill Chapel, Raka. Maybe someday you'll meet her. She has very good assorted content. Some of the things she does is DIYs, do it yourself. And she does things like, you know, home deco, how you can do home deco or deco for your room using readily available content like tissue paper rolls and yarn and, you know, boxes and things like that. So you can access that and see what it is she does. And another YouTube channel I can recommend to you is this one called The Bible Project. The Bible Project helps you to go through Bible stories in very animated and simple and exciting ways through the different stories of the Bible. And you know, we've done that a lot, especially at our teens church. So you can access that as well. It will really help you in your Bible study or in your understanding of these stories as well. So there goes good use of the internet and good use of your phone. We keep saying every Sunday that we are God's children, God's beloved children. And these are some of the ways in which you can access God's content done by God's children on the internet. So I hope you access them and I hope you enjoy them. Please tell me about it the next time you talk to me, whether you had fun or not. Hopefully you did. See you guys next week.